In the swamps and rivers of Florida, the hidden remains of ancient animals that lived here long ago can still be found. Join me on a dive where the teeth and bones of extinct creatures emerge from the depths. I'm Zach Fernaca. Today I am diving with Joe and Justin, and we are on the hunt for Ice Age fossils. Come on with us. We're heading back to a spot that we dove last week, and when we were there, Joe found a killer mastodon tooth.
I would have been up a while ago. There's a good spot right over there.
And Justin found a beautiful section of giant armadillo mandible. I don't know what I'm gonna find, but I'm excited to get out there and look. We're talking auriculitis?
Yeah, big old one.
In this river?
In this river, yeah, big old.
Do you remember, was it 3 inches?
It was broken.
But still in the 3-inch range?
It would have been well over 3 inches, yeah.
And you see, hearing stories like that, I've never found a tooth that big in this river. If I can find a large auriculitis shark tooth today, I will be stoked. That's a dream find for me. The thing about river diving in Florida, well, probably river diving anywhere if you're looking for fossils, is you spend a lot of time exploring, a lot of time getting in this cold water, checking the bottom. Half the time the bottom isn't what you're looking for. But when it's good, when you find the spot, it's been worth all of that effort. So we were here just a week ago and the air temperature was in the 80s, the water was warm. A cold front just came through overnight and the air is in the 50s and it is cold. So unfortunately, Justin and I did not bring big wetsuits. We are wearing basically surfing wetsuits. So hopefully we're finding enough fossils to keep us warm and keep us going.
Joe. I got my wetsuit right here.
I should have been eating more bean burritos. All right, so we've picked our spot for today. We're just starting to get our gear together. It's going to be a glorious day. It's cold. Thank you. Hey, Justin, how cold are you right now?
I don't know if I can really talk the camera because I'm kind of just shaking. But
so I swam up on you right as you found, well, right after you found that mastodon tooth. That's a beauty. As far as I'm concerned, those things are, where you and I hunt, much rarer than the mammoth teeth.
Yes.
So that's a beautiful example, juvenile mastodon tooth. And I can see that you found some giant armadillo, some alligator, horse,
giant
beaver, giggity. And
some gator verts.
I see an antler. Oh yeah, nice gator verts. Yeah, that's a great dive, man. Some other mastodon parts. This is the giant armadillo. Yeah, that's a beautiful antler section. I got one of those as well. Awesome. Awesome. Great job, man.
Oh my God.
That's a hell of a bone. Scored some tapir. And here's that deer antler that I found out on the bottom. That was neat. Here's a cool bird bone. This is horse, some giant armadillo. This is a deer toe bone. And here's a little deer ankle bone. That's kind of cool. Here's a section of box turtle shell. And, you know, just what I like about this spot is the variety. You know, so many different species, all from the same general time period, Pleistocene, Florida's Ice Age. These could be anywhere from 10,000 years to 100,000 years old. So that was a really cool first dive. A neat variety of fossils. Deer, horse, tapir, giant armadillo. You've got to see some of those large elephant limb bones that Joe found. And Justin scored a beautiful mastodon tooth. Do you see all the lights that Justin has on his head? That is a great way to fossil dive. Your hands are free and you're able to focus a lot better than, I'm just holding one light. Justin, God, Justin has four going. He looks like a character out of Star Wars. We're still freezing, so I'm gonna get back in the water for dive number two, and I'm excited to see what's gonna come up. Justin, how was that second tank for you, buddy?
It was pretty good.
I see you have what looked to be some associated fossil alligator scutes, which are pretty neat. And you just picked up a piece of tapir, didn't you?
Yes, right here.
That's awesome. Yeah, that is really neat. I found some tapir as well. Huh.
I found another one, but it had no teeth.
Oh, yeah.
And almost.
Yeah, there's a lot of tapir in this area, which is really cool. Oh, and you got some nice plastrons too.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's very cool. Wow. God, this is incredible, man. How exciting.
Good
so
day.
Much good stuff, yeah. This is probably the rarest fossil to come out today. This is a section of giant armadillo mandible. That's a jaw section. And I bet that the piece that Justin found last week is a match to this. Those are beautiful.
Only about 2 foot away.
Wow, nice teeth. Yeah, it's definitely got to go to the same animal, and I bet I found some of the armor plates to that animal last week. Yo!
I don't know the exact size, but it counts. It's gonna get displaced. Horse, paper, and more armadillo. And then
that's better than we're doing up
yeah,
there.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, a long shot. Giant beaver.
Oh, why'd you drop it?
All right, so these are some of Justin's finds. He got a section of mammoth tooth and some really nice vertebrae. He's got some beautiful alligator vertebrae.
This is cool. This is a beautiful manatee vertebra. Really great example.
That's beautiful, man. Beautiful. Great recovery. That is a cool piece.
Elephant patella.
Patella, yeah, those are pretty neat. That's not super common.
It's a whole bone.
Yeah, it is a whole bone. Yep. This is essentially the kneecap. That is really cool.
Oh man, killer.
Oh yeah.
Got one.
Giant armadillo scoot.
So we're taking a minute to warm up. It's chilly down there, but it's a lot of fun. We're finding a ton of bones, teeth, from so many different species of animals. And I have to wonder, you know, if we're finding these amazing fossils in the river, if right below where I'm standing, there are some of those ancient animals buried in the ground, you know, and over hundreds of years, thousands of years, they slowly erode out of the bank and into the river. We're getting ready to do our third and final tank.
Scored this beautiful coprolite, this fat fossilized turd, and let me tell you, the detail is still spot on. It looks fresh. This thing looks like it's smoking. I don't know, Joe, it's leaving a lot of brown in my hand. Did you just play a practical joke?
I've been holding that in all
day. Here's Joe's favorite personal find of the day. This is a beautiful sloth tooth, and you can see a little bit of that wear pattern. The animal did that while he was eating, or she. And yeah, that is an absolutely beautiful example. That is a large tooth.